Respective financial position of the governmental activities, the business type activities, each major fund, the aggregate remaining fund information of the city as of December 31st, 2014, and the respective changes in financial position, anywhere applicable, cash flows thereof for the year that then ended, in accordance with accounting principles generally accepted in the United States of America. That's the essence of our opinion that you'll find in the packets you received in advance, draft of the audit report on page Roman numeral 3 and 4. I thought I'd mention some financial highlights for 2014 in the general fund, which is you have two main funds, really, the general fund and the water, sewer, sanitation fund. The general fund ended the year with a surplus of revenues over expenditures of $265,346. That brought the reserves for the city fund balance for the general fund to $1,392,777. So you saw a strengthening of your financial position in 2014 in the general fund. One reason that occurred is fines and forfeitures were up over the prior year. The prior year was also in the black. This year's rule is a couple hundred thousand better than the prior year, and a fines and forfeitures were up around that amount. So that was a significant contributor for 2014. The other major fund that you have is the water, sewer, sanitation fund. For the year, it had a net loss after depreciation of $269,214, which is a little smaller loss than the prior year. Revenues were up slightly in that fund as well. Included also in your, among other things in the financial report, financial statements, is a comparison, a budget comparative schedule. And you'll find if you review that there was no budget, there were no budget overruns by department. So, of course, the budget at department level is a legal constraint, so if there had been a budget overrun, we'd have to cite you for that. But there were no budget overruns at department level for 2014. That budget comparative statement is found on pages 33 and 34. Essence of the results for 2014. There are a couple of other notable financial events of 2014. One was that the new well project was finished, which was primarily financed by a GPA loan. Another one was that your water sewer revenue bonds were refinanced with a low, which will result in a lower interest cost for that. For those bonds going forward. In the course of performing our audit of financial statements, if you become aware of any significant deficiencies in internal controls or any violations of laws, regulations, or contracts, we are required to report those to you as well in our audit report. We have a report under the report under that outlines that is on page is required by the yellow book. That is on page 50 and 51. Essentially, there are two things that two findings that we include in the audit report. The first one has to do with internal controls. In optimum internal controls, dictate that the functions of the accounting, of accounting be segregated among personnel. A small government such as Hahira is impractical to have enough staff to segregate all your functions. So you don't have the optimal segregation. And it's not practical to have it, but it's still a weakness in internal control. So what we do have decided, and it is helpful that you're aware of it. So you can, because of that awareness, you can implement any kind of management oversight, additional oversight that is you deem appropriate to mitigate the risk in that area. And that's the finding that you typically have every year. We have one other finding, which is has to do with SPLOS. These are on page 52 of the audit, the financial report audit report. There were two projects during 2014 that were dual-funded projects. One was the new well, which was funded primarily by the Jeep alone, but also with SPLOS funds. There was some street resurfacing, which was funded by a state grant, the local maintenance improvement grant, the LMIG grant, and as well as some SPLOS funds. At the end of the year, there were some a portion of the well project was paid with SPLOS funds, and it was previously funded by a drawdown by the Jeep alone. Others, there was money sitting in the Jeep alone account that needed to be transferred to the SPLOS funds to square that up. So because I hadn't been squared up by the end of the year, we cite you for that, and that then we say that you have to pay that money back to from the Jeep bank account to the SPLOS account. And so that is still, I think it's still pending.
And necessary has been corrected.
Has been done. There was also, we know that as far as the LMIG grant, those funds of $29,858.34, which were covered by the LMIG grant, and needed to be paid back to SPLOS fund to get that squared up. That had already been done in February, but as of the end of the year, it hadn't been done, so we bring that to. We include that in our report. So that's the other finding, which is in the report, and that is to get the SPLOS funds squared up properly. Any questions so far? In addition to our report, if we did issue, there's a required communications with you governance that we make, and I believe you got that in your advanced packet. Pretty much boilerplate communications in your case, because there were no issues to bring to your attention, no problems. But also in that report, if we have other recommendations to make, we'll include them in that report. We had a couple. In terms of the final accounts for the water sewer fund in 2014, they've been some difficulty in collecting these terminated accounts, and that for the year 2014, for instance, about $6,000 in that category, and it had accumulated over the years to a larger sum that had been written off in order to be conserved to make sure the financial statements, we don't overstate the receivables. But we do recommend that management review procedures and consider additional procedures in order to approve collection of the balances for terminated accounts in the water sewer system, water sewer sanitation system, to alleviate that. Also, although we didn't find any discrepancies in terms of disbursements, we just noticed that the review of expenditures, certain expenditures for public works, there's no documentation of the review by the public works director of the purchase. And we think in order to create an audit trail to make sure that we know he's looked at those, we want to see him initial or sign off on some of these, all these expenditures, so we'll, as an additional control on those. Fairly minor item, but I think if you step on something that can easily be done, it will strengthen your controls.
And management has spoken with personnel involved in public works as well as in the admin departments, and we've taken steps to correct those issues.
So, go back a little bit on the collection of past due accounts. I know we got the GMAC, or GMA, and they were setting up a program for us to do that.
That is correct. And Penn Credit is the name of the company with GMA that's recommended, and we are in a process to refer them properly to Penn Credit now.
That's assuming you do that.
We had some discussion about, yeah, I knew there was going to be some outsourcing collection.
Yes, that's correct.
And really, that concludes my report. See, unless there are questions.
I want to thank Valenti Rappin Associates for another audit. It certainly is a process every year that we undertake. I know, speaking on behalf of the staff, that we have appreciated Valenti Rappin's professionalism and their attentiveness to detail. And we certainly have taken the recommendations, as we do every year, very seriously, and are doing our red letter best to abide by those so that we can improve our internal controls for future audits. And we certainly do appreciate the efforts of you and your staff.
Well, thank you, and we appreciate the opportunity to be of service to the city of Hahira.